now a severe famine overshadowed the land, as had happened before in Abraham's time. And so Isaac moved to the city of Gerar, where Abimelech, king of Philistines, lived. Why Isaac took a decision to move and to go to some other places? Because of the famine. In other words, the food was gone, water, it was gone, and then he took a decision to move. But always it's good to pray and to ask the Lord, should I move now? Should I leave my place? Should I go to that area? Because if that's not God's time, if that's not under God's season, trouble and problems may come. And then because he was facing a very bad circumstances where he was, he took a decision to move. Then verse number 2 say, let's look straight to the verse number 2. In the verse number 2 say, Jehovah appeared to him there and told him, don't go to Egypt. Do as I say and stay here in the land. If you do, I will be with you and bless you. And I will give you all this land to you and to your descendants, just as I promised Abraham your father. And I will cause your descendants to become as numerous as the stars. And I will give you then all of these lands, and they shall be a blessing to all the nations of the earth. So God came, God appeared, and told him, don't go down to Egypt. We have another scripture. If you wish, you can open your Bible for you to see what the Bible say in the book of Acts, chapter number 1, verse number 4. The book of Acts, if you need help, you can give a shout. The assistants or even the brother and the sister sitting next to you, they may come to assist you and help you. Acts chapter number 1, verse number 4. It says like this. Are you there? Yes. Amen. Praise God. In one of these meetings, or in one occasion, if your Bible is NIV translation, in one of these meetings, he told them not to leave Jerusalem until the Holy Spirit come upon them in fulfillment of the Father's promise. So the Bible says, don't move from Jerusalem. Jerusalem meaning the word, the instructions, the revelations that comes from God. But sometimes looks like we are under, you know, some circumstances, and we will feel for somehow in that specific moment just to leave, just to wash our hands and to go to the next city, or to take steps that will make us to feel good and not to be under those kind of circumstances. But the Bible say, don't move to Egypt. What does that mean, Egypt? I wrote down here just to give you, if you want to write down, was the place of the testing for the Israelites. Egypt means the testing place, the place where you're going to be under the test. Maybe you are under this situation right now. People, they are mocking your faith. People, they are persecuting you because now they discovered you are going to Grace of God Church. The moment your colleagues, your friends, they discovered you got baptized, you know they are just speaking on a daily basis. The moment your supervisor, your bosses, they discovered you are living by faith, you are Christian, you are committed to cross Jesus, now they keep on changing your shifts. They keep on taking you from 6 to 2 o'clock in the morning. That was the best. Now they placed you from 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. evening time. And they know the area where you were staying, it is quite difficult for the taxis to be running. They are testing your faith. They are doing things. I say maybe they do not know what they are doing. They have got no understanding at all what they are doing. But the devil knows. The devil knows. The devil is not looking at your, you know, your shifts. Whatever is happening, the devil is looking straight to you and trying to take you out of the way. He wants you to go back to Egypt. Because remember, you came from Egypt. You used to be a short-tempered person. You used to fight verbally, sometimes even physically. And now the devil wants you to go back and to do all those things. The devil wants you to have a grudge in your heart by what people they are doing. And the devil comes and say, where is your God? Don't your God see that you are faithful in tithes and offerings, and you have been going to church every each Sunday? You are no longer drinking. You are no longer smoking and what? Why don't God come to save you and to rescue you? The devil wants you to be angry against your Creator. And remember what I told you, that in every step of our lives, God will be taking care of the small details in our lives. Can I get amen from the church? Don't go to Egypt. Stay where you are. Don't go down to their levels. You came from there. Now you are a noble person. And you have to carry on with your mission as a servant of God, as a Christian, as a servant of God, as a wife, as a good husband, good wife. Carry on moving. Don't go down to Egypt. Say to your neighbor, don't go down to Egypt. If you have got some money, you can go to visit. In terms of to know the place. Not spiritually. Are you getting what I'm saying? I'm talking on the spiritual side, not on the physical side. There is another beautiful story in the Bible that talks about Hannah. 1 Samuel chapter number 1. Turn your Bible there, please. Asablifi family. And let us see together what the Lord God say, what the Bible teaches us. And by the way, I forgot to tell you, Egypt means testing for the Israelites. And a place where they saw Jehovah in the context with the false gods of Pharaoh. 1 Samuel chapter number 1. Let us see together. Verse number 9. See how beautiful it is when the person obey God. In one evening, verse number 9, chapter 1, verse number 9, 1 Samuel. In one evening, after supper, when they were at Shiloh, Hannah went over to the tabernacle. They went there to enjoy, to eat, you know, to be celebrating. But Hannah, the Bible say, she went to the tabernacle. Where have you been? Especially in the moment that you were facing. Where have you been? When the devil is after you, trying to make oppositions. Be careful. Be careful. Especially now these days, we are all busy rebuilding our spiritual lives, rebuilding the ministry, rebuilding our character, rebuilding, you know, our lives with cross Jesus. The scripture and the Bible say that while they went to, you know, to celebrate and to eat something, to have a good supper, the Bible say Hannah, she wasn't happy. She went to the tabernacle. My question is, you don't need to open your mouth, please, as a belief, just listen. And the answer, just quietly inside of you, deep inside of you, are you happy with this kind of life you have got so far? I'm asking on the spiritual side. Have you seen the anointing or the revival that the scripture, the Bible describes and the Bible talks about? If you say, no, I'm not so happy or I'm not happy at all. That is the point. Don't go to celebrate. It's rather you put yourself aside and go to the tabernacle. Go to the presence of God. While people, they are enjoying, celebrating, find a quiet place where you can have at least one quiet minute with Jehovah and do your prayer. The Bible say that Hannah, she was full of, you know, she was depressed. She wasn't happy at all. The Bible say, the verse number 10, let us see together. We can just check together the verse number 10. She was in deep anguish and was crying bitterly as she prayed to the Lord. Pray unto Jesus. Pray unto God. But don't go down to their levels. Go up to the tabernacle and pray to the Lord. Speak to the Lord. Speak about, you know, your matters. Speak about your things that you have been facing on a daily basis. Your sadness, your sorrows. Go to the presence of God because God is faithful. And God will come through in the mighty name of Jesus. That's why he's saying to me this morning, and I believe he's saying to a couple of hundred people here in the house, don't go down to Egypt. Stay where you are. Hold your position as a Christian. Hold your position and stay there. Don't move from your position to go to Egypt. Unless you have to leave your position to go higher, to go to the tabernacle. Go, my brother. And then you will keep on growing spiritually, and God will be happy with you in Jesus' name. Say amen. Amen. Don't go down to Egypt. Do not swear. Don't lie. Don't go to Egypt. Don't get involved with some corruptions. Some time back, I was in Mpumalanga, and someone, Christian person, preacher, as I am a preacher, and he said to me, "You know what, Pastor Santos, I know you have done a great job in South Africa. Now you are going to 8 years in South Africa. You were supposed to have your ID." I say, "How come?" "Yes, only on your second year in South Africa, you could apply with a friend of mine to have your ID." I say, "Wow, really?" He said, "Yes." I said, "How? No, you just pay 6,000 rand and you can have your ID." I said, "No, that's not for me. It's rather to stay where I am in my position, you know, to have a peace of mind, understand, and to face whatever the process it may be, to apply after those specific years in that specific condition, let me do it as it must be." But sometimes people, they prefer shortcuts. That's why they will go down to Egypt. Are you getting what I'm saying? Does make sense to you? Don't go down to Egypt. My husband wasn't right with me. I will pay my husband in the same level. My sister, don't go down to Egypt. Stay where you are. Bring your husband up to the tabernacle. Don't go down to Egypt. Because this is what the devil is looking for. This is what God placed in my heart to speak to the congregation this morning. I hope you heard it clearly. And I hope you will practice what the scriptures say. Don't go down to Egypt. Stay where you are. But if you move, move up to the tabernacle, to the presence of God. Say amen. Amen. Can you put your hands together to our Lord Jesus? Come on. Hi, everyone. Blessings to you. Blessings to your family. Thank you for watching us. It was a pleasure to bless you through God's words. Please share the message. Bless your friends, your colleagues, and your neighbors. Don't forget to subscribe. Next time, you will be notified about new contents. And I believe God will bless you. Goodbye.